Can everyone see my slides before we begin?
Perfect, ma'am. Working just fine. Okay. Thank you. Yes.
Okay. Bakit goals, no? Because it will entail goals, objectives, strategies, and tactics. So what we're going to do today is not only define, but differentiate, and also connect the following: tactics, strategies, objectives, and goals. At the end of this one, we would have eradicated our fear of those. And not only that, we would know what to do and what to put under each of the following. So where does it start? Before we begin with goals, we have to see a vision. We have to be able to create a vision. Now, what is a vision? A vision is a dream. This is an idea of where we want to go. It is the highest level statement that a corporation can create and shows direction and aspiration. Diba? Napaka medyo highfalutin, no? Pero that is what it is. A vision is a dream of a corporation where they want to go. So it answers the question, where are we going? Now, what do we need in order to create the right vision statement? Now, this is one thing that I also put together. We're talking about people. We're talking about the corporation. A corporation is made up of the people who run the business itself. And so, in order to create a vision, we have to be redundant, envision the faces of the people that we are creating the vision to for, the people that we are trying to convince that this is where we are going, the people whose direction we want to direct, whose path we want to direct. So we have to envision the faces of the people. It gives them now a reason for contributing. It clarifies the purpose of the business. It inspires the people to go towards that direction. And so since we're envisioning their faces, a good vision statement should be forward-thinking, should be actionable, should be collaborative, should be engaging, and simple. The simple is sometimes the hardest part in creating a vision. Forward-thinking, a vision should think about the future, since it is a direction, you're going there. It is not here. You're not saying that we are here now. So it is towards the future. It should be futuristic. Actionable, it should be a verb. It should contain a verb, an action word. Collaborative, it cannot be done alone. It should be done as a group, as the whole team. That's why it's faces. Engaging, why? Because a vision is supposed to inspire. So it has to be engaging. Simple in order for them to understand, and not only understand, but in order for them to remember. Very important. Yeah. Because if I were to ask you right now, by the way, I would. This is going to be a very interactive one-hour training, and I would like to ask for your cooperation also in help in answering some of the questions that I will be putting forward. We would need this because I believe in learning by action, learning by doing. And so let us remove all our fears of posting, of answering. And then if all else fails, then I would rely on Jong to do the answering for me also. But the chat group is available for you. And I would like to ask everyone to continuously put in their comments. Okay, so basis. We're talking about faces. Simple. Why simple? It has to be something that is memorable. So if I ask you, I just want an answer from the whole group of yes or no. Okay, be ready with this. Can each and every one of you remember the vision statement of your corporation? Go. Jung, please monitor na lang the answer.
Yeah, good. They're all answering yes, Bam, so far. I think you can see that from your end as well. So this is good. They can very well remember their vision statements. Maybe they have memorized it already as part of our ISO.
Very good. Very good. But then,
yes.
If that's the case, Then when they created the vision statement, they simplified it in such a way that it would be memorable. Is it engaging? I want you to analyze your vision statement. No need to answer. But I want you to analyze within yourselves and by yourselves. Is my vision statement something that inspires you? Does it inspire my team? Is it something that needs my help and my team's help? Does it encompass all the members of our team, from the president to the service crew? Does it need the help of the whole group? Is it actionable? Does it contain an action word, a verb? Is it towards the future? If it answers all these phases, then your vision statement is perfect. Okay, so let me give you a vision statement that we are going to be working on all throughout this 1 hour. We transform new employees into valuable long-term contributors. With an S. Contributors. So that is forward thinking. It is actionable. It is collaborative. It is engaging, and it is simple. So let us remember again that the vision statement, and that is the vision statement that we will be using our goals, our objectives, our strategies, and tactics on. Okay. Let me give you also some more examples in order to drive the point home of the vision statements of known industries and known corporations all throughout. I just edited it and put in Philippines, but these are vision statements of international corporations. Be the most innovative, interactive, mahilig sila sa innovative, interactive, consumer-driven sports and entertainment marketing agency in the Philippines. In the world, dyan nakalagay siya. To receive national recognition as the most innovative, dedicated, and productive marketing and communications firm in the Philippines. I love the third one. Producing and selling locally sourced cakes and pies that are so delicious and satisfying that every customer who leaves our store does so with a smile. To be the most passionately, hindi na innovative, passionately referred agency in the advertising industry. Prepare a prioritized list of low-cost, mas ano to, technical, engineering recommendations that guides the organization to more energy-efficient operation. And the last but not the least, to move the web forward and give web designers and developers the best tools and services in the world. Now, those are examples to further drive the point home, because I believe in the redundancy also for us to remember. Let me give you some more examples. I just need a minute of your time for great vision statements. Now, I would need again your cooperation, because we are trying to transform also the online education or the e-learning industry, not only in the world, but especially in the Philippines. And we were able to discover that one way for people to really learn and for people to be interested in learning is to create an LMS or an e-learning that would engage people. Meaning to say, this is going to be from two parts. This is going to be interactive. So I would like you to all use the chat feature to type in an example of your vision statement. Okay, be brave. Let's make this readable to everyone. Okay, I'll give you a few minutes, about 2 minutes to do so. John, please monitor.
All right. So it's 1:23. We should be finished by 1:24. So we'll be finished by 1:26.
While the others are typing, take a look also, if you're done, take a look at the other vision statements and remember the phases. Is it forward thinking? Is it actionable? Is it collaborative? Is it engaging? And is it simple? What do you think, John, so far? Ganda naman. Perfect, not perfect. Yung mga ano. Kamusta mga vision statement?
So we have, I think we have posted here from Mr. Romeo Tuazon, the Bataan General Hospital and Medical Center is the leading and trusted multi-specialty medical center in Central Luzon by 2022.
Right? Very good. Oh, very good. To be the leading, again, John, to be the leading?
To be the leading and trusted multi-
okay, forward thinking. Okay.
It is. And CWD, I think this is Karkar Water District or Cagayan de Oro Water District. The most outstanding government.
I love that.
Service provider in the Philippines by 2030. That's ambitious but inspiring.
Very engaging. It needs a village to do that. It needs a team to do that. It cannot be done by a single person, right?
From Anne Rodriguez, we are the leading science high school in Asia Pacific region, preparing our scholars to become globally competitive Filipino scientists equipped with 21st century skills and imbued with the core values of truth, excellence, and service to the nation.
I'd like to stop there. That is perfect. Because there is another methodology to, in fact, this was inspired by a book that was published about 10 years ago. We're in to put people, to make people actionable. It has to be in the present tense, even if it is in the future. So perfect the way that they did it, okay? Make sure that people know that this is what we are not right now. It is not something that we will be, but something that we are. So even if you are not yet that, you have to convince people that this is what we are. So that was in the present tense, Joe. Okay. That is possible, and that is a beautiful way of creating a vision. Let's stop from there. Congratulations. I'd like to give you all a hand. Perfect. So now we know how to craft the perfect vision statement that will inspire our people. Again, it all starts with a vision. Before we get into the goals, before we get into the objectives, the strategies, and the tactics. So let's now go and be ready with our goals. Let us start seeing this. Goals. What are goals? Highest level in vision. This is still a high level. This is an aim. Some people will associate it with another word that was very much talked about during the 90s. And the corporations kept on saying, what are your aims? So to avoid confusion, aims are goals. Okay. Some may even say, what are your strategic goals? Let me explain about that more. The analogy about several years ago is that the strategies come before goals. Visions come before goals. business strategy as a whole, as a portfolio, because we have the portfolio management, then we have the program management, then we have the project management. The portfolio is your whole business. The whole business. So if you create a business strategy, that comes before goals. A business strategy. But if you create a strategic plan, the strategy comes after the objectives. O, medyo, ano tayo din, ha? Medyo, again, let me reiterate. Portfolio management yun eh. Ibig sabihin, they are analyzing the direction of the whole corporation. So their business strategy done, they still have a vision. A vision is their dream. In order for them to get to their dream, to acquire the dream, kailangan meron kaming strategy eh. And itong strategy nin namin, we have to live the strategy and do the strategy and to take action in that strategy. That then comes before the goals. Because if this is your strategy, your business strategy, then my goals, in order for me to acquire and to work towards that strategy, are the following. But let's put that aside. Okay? Because our level, we do not create the business strategies. The business strategies are created by the owners, the sponsors, the board of a corporation. Unless we have like Jong, si Jong, ano yan, may-ari ng kumpanya. Therefore, you are na, bigla ko na wala, Jong. Ayun dyan. Jong, are you there?
Yes, Bam, go ahead.
Okay, so ikaw, in your position, you are creating a business strategy. Okay, so you have created the vision, you have created the business strategy, and then the goals now, ikaw na magbibigay sa mga tao mo, sa program directors mo. Create the goals, basta I gave you my vision, I gave you my business strategy, create the goals. Okay, so, goals. Ang gagawin ngayon namin as program managers is we will look at the vision. We will look at the business strategy, the overall strategy of our corporation, and create goals in order to put action dun sa mga business strategy and vision to be able to get there and to be able to do those. Okay, so it is a broad aim, still a broad aim, wherein your efforts are directed in order to acquire that vision. It answers the question, what do we want? Kung yung vision kanina, where are we going? The goals answer the question, what do we want to do now? And that is now going to be answered by the program manager. So kanina again, to reiterate, the vision and the business strategy, but we're not going to talk about business strategy, yeah? Kasi kanya-kanyang strategy yan eh. Like, take the river, ganyan yung sa pagsawar, no? That's different. Are being authored by the portfolio managers, yung mga boss. The goals, the strategic plan, the tactics or action items, as some call it, are being prepared, una yung goals, being prepared by the program manager. Goals, program manager. So the goals, unless it is a project. If it is a project, then the goals came from the project manager. Clear ba?
So far, so good.
Okay, so far, so good. Pag nalilito kayo, please, the chat feature is open. We will entertain all of your questions if possible. But again, let me reiterate, okay, because I want to drive the point home. Let me give you some examples of goals. To deliver 1 million queries a year with a fiscal report result of 90% satisfaction rating by the end of fiscal year 2020. A project to replace the ventilation and air conditioning in an aging office building that will reduce annual cooling costs by 30%. Okay, and so forth and so on. I'm just going to skip through that. because time is of the essence. Now, you saw those goals. Remember, in vision, we have phases, right? To remember, visions have to be thinking, actionable, collaborative, engaging, and simple. Is there a way to create a good goal or good goals in the plural sense? So let's think naman about the 5 W's, right? Of course, we have to take into consideration that a goal has to give you a direction. It pushes you towards achieving a successful program. And it is not a how, but a what. And it also tells you where you're going. Rather, because in strategy, how you're going to get there, tells you how, where you're going rather than how you're going to get there. But let's just think about the 5 W's.
Yeah, Bob, before you proceed to the 5 W's, there's just a quick clarification here from Mr. Romeo Tuazon. What is the difference between vision and goals?
The vision is the overall. It is the direction that you want your company. It answers the question, where are we going? Where are we going? The vision is a dream, right? A goal answers, what are we going to do in order to get that vision, that dream? Okay, so it is a subset of a vision. The goal is a subset of a vision. So again, it starts with a vision. The vision is the highest level of your plan, of your corporation's plan. That is the highest level. It is usually done by the portfolio manager. A goal is now done by the program manager, lower level pero high pa rin. Okay? Paano ba ta? Ano bang gagawin natin? What are we going to do in order to acquire that vision? It answers that question. Therefore, it is a direct subset of a vision. Okay, clear, John?
Yeah, thank you, Bob.
I hope I was able to answer that question. Now, in order for us to be able to create, in order for us to be able to create a good vision, we have to keep in mind the phases happening. In order for us to create a good goal, I'm trying to be redundant here because I know that even engineers, even presidents, they are having a hard time really understanding and really not only understanding but being able to teach their people about this one, the differences between them. And what further adds to the confusion is that a lot of methodology authors have interchanged these terminologies also all throughout the year. So what I want to do is bring clarification. And what our group also wants to do, certified project managers also and Six Sigma practitioners, is to try to bring clarification also between the terminologies of each. So the vision, highest level, phases, the goals, 5 W's. Okay. The vision, where are we going? The goal, what are we going to do in order to achieve that vision? It answers the question, a very good goal. When you create your goal, answers should answer the questions. Who, what, when, where, and why.
All right.
Sorry, John. Yes.
Just last one quick clarification on this. What are your thoughts, Bam, on the VMG? Because, of course, the most popular is the VMG model, like V stands for vision, M mission, and then goals.
Do you subscribe? Beautiful question. I love that one. I was not going to touch on the mission, but I wanted to, and it's a good thing you asked that one. Okay, what is the difference between a vision and mission? A vision is, again, no, it's a dream. It's where we want to go. A mission now is what are we doing right now? What are we known for in order to get that vision? We are the, hindi pa tayo leading eh. Kasi huwag niyo sabihin sa mission na leading na kayo kung hindi pa kayo leading. Unless you are, ha? So that's the difference. That's the one big difference. A vision, and in fact, sometimes a vision is not something that we achieve, but it inspires the whole team to achieve that. A mission is exactly what you are doing now. We provide, your vision. We, kahit na sabihin mong present tense, ha, pero hindi pa kayo doon. We are the leading provider of e-learning courses in the world. parating ganyan. That's the your vision. My mission is we create effective, engaging e-learning courses that are available to all people in all industries. That is what we do. This is what we're doing. That is our mission. And our goal now is to create those courses. Kasi mission namin yun eh. Yan ang ginagawa namin. So I need to be able to create those. I have to put action to the mission. Kasi mission yan eh. Binigay sa'yo yung mission eh. Parang Mission Impossible. Diba yun? Let's go to Mission Impossible, the movie. Diba? Diba? Binigyan siya ng mission. So kailangan ngayon, ang goal niya is ipatupad yung mission na yun. To make it realizable. To make it the truth. And what is happening right now. Okay, John?
Thank you, Bob. Fantastic.
I hope that answered it. Now, to create a good goal statement, the goal statement has to answer the questions who, what, when, where, why. Bakit? Eh, kasi sino ba ang gagawa nitong goal na to sa Mission Impossible? Di ba yung team? Yung team nyo eh, will undergo that goal eh. Di ba? Kasi may binigyan kayo ng mission. So the whole team now has to undergo that goal. They have to know what they're going to do. So you have to answer them in one simple statement all the questions of who, what, when, where, why. Because you're giving them a direction. Eh. So you have to be very clear, just like in defining a problem. Remember, for those who attended our PSDM last week, ba yun, Jo? Last week, no? In defining your problem, because you need to know what the problem is, so we have to be clear. So let me give you some examples, right? My example first. Vision ko kanina, transform new employees into valuable long-term contributors. That's my vision, right? I now, being a program manager, created a goal for my team. In line, my company kunyari is ABC, in line with ABC's vision of employee transformation, the HR department, that's my team, HR department will create an engaging and informative onboarding. Onboarding muna tayo kasi madami akong goals. Hindi lang yung in order to get that vision, ako from the HR department, ang aking way of doing it is to create an onboarding program for ABC's new hires. At kailangan matapos natin to. Team, kailangan natin to matapos by November 2020. So ang gagawin ngayon natin, gagawa tayo ng onboarding program na engaging and informative. Na kailangan natin tapusin by 2020. Clear ba yung mission natin? Di ba? Clear ba yung goal natin to accomplish that mission? It answers who? HR department. Sino tayo? HR department. What are we going to do? Onboarding program. When do we need to finish this? By November 2020. Saan natin gagawin? Dito, sa opisinan. Dito natin gagawin. Bakit? Eh, kasi in line to sa ating mission of employee transformation. So that is now a good goal statement because it answers who, what, when, where, and why. So to further again reiterate it, let me give you some examples. To deliver 1 million queries. Hindi lahat babasahin ko, pero more or less. Okay? To a project to replace the ventilation and air conditioning in an aging office building. Lahat naman to, di ba, John, you're going to be posting in YouTube.
Yes, we are uploading it in our YouTube channel, Bam. Yes.
Yeah, and then they can revisit the whole training also, just in case at the end of the day, I wasn't successful in my goal of eradicating all those goals. Okay.
So far, so good. So far, so good. Doing well.
But I want to, as much as possible. This is my vision. To eradicate also all the confusion about this one. I hope that you can help me accomplish this one and reach my vision. Ano pa?
Thank you, Bob. Thank you. Thank you.
And an IT project to cleanse contact. These are all examples. You can take up, you can do an SS, a screenshot of these one just to help you. I'll give you a few seconds to do so before I go to the next slide.
So, Bob, just to recap, what exactly do we want them to do with this part right here?
Mag-screen capture.
Okay, screenshot. Okay, go ahead. Ladies and gentlemen, you may do a screenshot of this very detailed slide right here.
Para kasi, it can also, when you're creating now your goals, you can pattern it after this one.
All right. Very nice. Nicely done, Bam. Thank you.
Pero ang tanong ko dyan, baka naman pwede pa nating i-improve to using the 5 W's kasi some here, kailangan pa i-tweak ng konti sa totoo lang. So let's take into account one. Okay. Isa lang. Let's just get one. Okay. A construction project, diba sabi natin kanina, adds floor space to a popular restaurant to add 30% more tables that are expected to increase revenue by 22,000. So, did it answer who, what, when, where, why? In a way. Pero, what if, for example, I have a new team member and I just told them, oh, ito yung goal natin. Medyo malabo. Now, if I created that goal together with my team, everybody knows what I'm talking about. But what, because that is the way of things, what if, for example, biglang na-change yung isang team member at wala ako doon to explain. My goal has to be self-explanatory. So let's create, let's just tweak it a bit and let's make it this way. By October 2020, we will add 30% to restaurant ABC's floor space, enabling them to increase their monthly revenue by 22%. So it's the same thing. I just tweaked it in order to answer the questions directly ng who tayong gagawa. What? Mag-a-add tayo ng resto ng 30% more floor space. When are we going to do this? Kailangan tapusin natin by October 2020. Saan natin gagawin? Dun sa restaurant. Dun natin gagawin yun. Bakit? Kasi kailangan nilang mag-increase ng monthly revenue of 22%. Let's take a screenshot of this one. Dan? SS. Kumbaga sa live selling. Okay, SS.
All right, SS.
Done?
Screenshot, done, yeah.
Okay, thanks. SS done.
Yeah.
Now to further, these are more of the goals. 1 minute lang. Hope that everyone was kahit pa paano na drive yung point home of how to create a great goal. So again, vision, vision faces ang goals, 5W with an S. Yung goal is a subset of the vision. The vision answers the question, where are we going? And the goal answers the question, what are we going to do to get where we're going? Okay, so now, we come to objectives. Objectives are subsets of goals. Ito ngayon, it answers the question, how? How are we going to accomplish the goal in order to accomplish and to get to the vision? So, it is considered as a subset of a goal. Measurable to. Dito na ngayon, I'm sure that most of you have heard about SMART objectives. So, that is what we're going to use for this one. Okay. So if the vision answers the question, where are we going? And the goal answers the question, what are we going to do? The objectives now answers the questions, how do we want it? How are we going to get where we're going? So, smart. In creating now, the objectives, madami to ah, it's not a one-on-one thing. Madam, just like madaming goals, pwedeng merong goals ang bawat isang department, pwedeng madaming goals ang isang department to achieve a vision, madami ka ngayong objectives under a certain goal. But when you create your objectives, kasi ito yung mga parang guidelines mo eh, guidelines mo for your team, no? What are they going to, how are they going to achieve the goal? It has to be smart. Meaning to say, it has to be specific. Kailangan merong specified na action. Measurable siya. Kailangan pwede mong ma-answer ng either number or yes or no. If it's not a number, it should be answerable by yes or no. You have to take into account, it doesn't have to be a mission impossible. Mahirap yung mission impossible eh, unless katulad tayo ni Tom Cruise sa 50 years old na yung mukha pa rin 20 years old. So, hindi natin magagawa yun eh. It has to be something. Because if it is not achievable, your team is going to be demotivated. And that is so hard. When creating objectives, the project manager or the project leader or the team, the department leader for some, have to think of the capabilities and resources of your team, the people who are going to undergo these objectives. If it is not something that they can do now, do not put it there because it is going to demotivate them. Do not think of an impossible dream, or if it is something that you aspire to, you have to provide them with the needed resources. It is your job as a project manager to ensure that your team is able to put action into these objectives. They are capable enough. It should be something that they're good at. It is something that they understand, therefore relevant. It should be something that they care about, therefore relevant. Hindi siya yung wala sa kanilang roles and responsibilities. Ito yung binigay mo sa kanila, you employed them, you made them part of the team in order to do this. So it should be relevant to them. It should be time-bound. Because you know how people are, if you don't put a deadline, they will not do it. Or they will wait until, sabihin, I didn't know naman eh kung kailan to kailangan. So it has to be specific. And another word for specific, it should be understandable. It should be specified. It should be understandable and simple. It should have metrics answerable by yes or no or a number. It should be achievable. My team has the resources and capability to accomplish this objective. It should be relevant to them. It should be something that they're used to, that they know, that they equate themselves to. It should be time bound. So, kailangan metrics that can be tracked. And it has to be something that can be smart, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. If in the vision, we had phases, if in the goals, we had the 5 W's, for the objective, we have the smart.
Okay. All right. Good. Thank you.
Okay then. Example, vision natin kanina. Transform new employees into valuable long-term contributors. A goal is in line with ABC's vision of employee transformation. HR department to create an engaging and informative onboarding program for ABC's new hires by 2020. So let's list down now the objectives. Hindi ko na babasahin, pero konti lang babasahin ko dyan kasi ang dami. Objective ko ng HR department, within the first month of hire, magkakreate kami ng welcoming and supportive environment for new hires. Hindi pa to talaga specified, pero yan ang objective ko eh. Provide kami ng tools, resources, and logistics information ng employees para alam nila kung anong gagawin nila. Tapos kailangan gagawa kami ng something para ma-provide sila at ma-familiarize ng culture ng organization kasi ang hirap nun eh. Tapos kailangan magbibigay kami ng training, so job skills, no? Tapos magbibigay din kami ng mga expectations sa kanila para hindi sila nalilito. And we're going to introduce something that we did within the company, yung paano sila ma-evaluate. And kailangan, hindi lang yung training sa umpisa, kailangan may continuous coaching yan. That way, I am going now to engage my new hires. And if I engage my new hires well, I would be able to transform yung mga bagong hinire, new employees, into valuable long-term contributors. Again. Okay, so it's the objectives are there in order to be a subset of the goal. And the goal is there in order to be a subset of the vision. I created my objectives in order to tell you how we want it, in order to answer the goal, what are we going to do in order to answer the vision where we are.
Just a quick question. How often do we visit goals and objectives? Maybe even the mission. How often do we visit them?
Okay, then. It's all dependent on the company. Eh? Kasi if it is a highly, how do you call this one, agile corporation, minsan yung mission nila nag-iiba every year. Diba? Kasi very innovative, very fast yung company. Eh? Kasi the old adage that they said, sige, ang mission every 5 years, ang mission every 3 years, ang ating mga goals siguro every year, kasama ng strategic one. Let's put that out sa trash. Okay, let's throw that away. Because things are changing right now. We don't even know what's going to happen by next month. Right? So, that's why when we gave the training on design thinking, diba sabi ko nga na, whatever we learned before, we learn something new every day. And the only thing that is constant in this life is change. Let us not, and one of the, in fact, I did this training also before. One of the practices of the most ineffectual leaders is to stick to a methodology that he or she learned several years ago. You have to change. You have to change the way that you think. You have to change in accordance to what is happening around you. You have to open your eyes. So if your corporation is innovative, if it provides services that ever-changing, then you change it as the times change. You change it in accordance with the needs of the market. So you make change every year, your mission, huwag tayo mag-stick na, uy, hindi, sabi daw ng nila na ang mission, kasi natutunan ko to nung nag-attend ako ng training nung 2005, yung in-attend kong training, sabi daw every 3 years. No. Ano ang kailangan ng kumpanya nyo? Kung kailangan nyo i-change yung mission nyo, kasi nag-iba na yun. Nagkaroon kayo ng competitor, nagkaroon kayo ng nagkaroon ng bagong technology, di ba? Yung sabi natin yung sa changes, di ba? What are the triggers of change, right? Is it political, no? Is it economical, no? Yung pestle natin, is it social? Is it technological change, right? Is it an environmental change? Is it a legal change? Team of change. Mag-change tayo. Okay, John.
All right. Maybe just a quick follow-up. Would you agree if objectives are more frequently visited than goals, and then, of course, goals than vision?
Yes, because objectives are part of the goal, are a subset of a goal. Okay. An objective is a subset of a goal. You create your objective in accordance to the goal.
Okay.
But ito lang, John, pag nag-iba yung objectives mo, and the goal is still there, edi ibig sabihin yung plano mo, nag-fail. Yes, you can change it, pero nag-fail. Okay. Yun. So, gagawa ka ngayon ng bagong objectives para yung goal na yun.
Okay. So, in terms of frequency of revisiting or reviewing, the most frequently revisited are, of course, the objectives compared to the goal or the vision. Can we say that?
Yes, pero sabay ito ginagawa eh. Okay. 'Di ba nag-strat plan tayo? Yeah. Yung iba kasi diyan, they stick to the annual strat plan. But nowadays, I do not suggest that. I suggest that to keep in line with the ever-changing times, you have to put into in mind not strategic thinking but design thinking. Remember, yun yung focus ng lecture ko last week, no? Unfortunately, the old adage of we have to be strategic, we have to be analytical in creating our programs and plans throw them out of the window. We are not created to be strategic, but we are created to be creative. People have lasted and we have emerged as the top mammal in this world because we are creative. We adapt. We are adaptive and creative. So it depends on what is happening around us. If we need to change it, then we change our objectives, then change our goal. But nauuna yung objectives, ha? Kasi hindi nag-work eh. Tama ka, Jong. Mas frequent yung objectives. Pero ang suggestion ko, change nyo lahat, pati yung goal. Tingnan nyo, revisit na change. Sorry. Revisit. Ang goal ba namin na nami-meet pa nitong mga ginagawa namin ngayon? Kapag okay pa, revisit with it. Yung goal ba, uy, kailangan ba namin baguhin yung goal? Kasi parang hindi namin ma-meet yung vision. Pwede po doon yung goal. Diba? Be open to change. Let us not be captured and let us not be, how do you call this one, shackled by methodologies that were introduced to us several years ago. Let us be adaptive. Let us be creative.
All right, Pam. Fantastic. Thank you for clarifying that.
Okay. Sabi ko nga, some of your practices, I know, no, and I am here. I like what Jong said that I used to be the country manager of Apple Philippines, and I have attended a lot of Apple talks. No, and the thing that really I was able to embrace in that culture is that we are here to change the world. Okay, so how are we going to do that? By challenging the status quo, by challenging what has been taught to us by people who want to contain us. We have to be able to think differently. We have to be able to change the world because those who do are those who are remembered. Those who challenge are those who actually change the world. So, you know, balik tayo sa earth. Balik ako sa earth.
That is compelling.
So, hindi lang, nasaan na tayo? Strategy na tayo. So, we talked about visions. In fact, we even talked a bit about missions. We talked about our goals. We talk about objectives. Oh, ngayon ah, isang tabi natin yung mga yon. Let's remember them. Let's remember them. Remember that goal is a subset of a vision. Under yung goal ng vision. An objective is a subset of a goal. Under no goal yung objectives. Okay? Alam natin yan. Let's keep that in mind. Let's keep in mind the vision, the goal, the objective, pero isang tabi muna natin. Isang tabi muna natin yan. Then let us go to strategy. There are two types of strategies, just like what I explained during my introduction. Let us not talk about the business strategy. Kasi yung business strategy na yan, ang gumagawa niyan yung mga may-ari. Yan, si Jong. Gagawa siya ng business strategy yan. Ang business strategy, there's this favorite how do you call this one? Ano na to, ha? Matagal na si Sun Tzu, di ba? Yung Art of War. Some of you, I'm sure, have read his book already, translated into English kasi Chinese general siya, you know? Translated. I have also incorporated a lot of teachings in his book in terms of negotiation. I also authored a book, The Art of War when it comes to negotiation. You know, so I created that book also. And it is also being applied to this one. A business strategy, sabi nga niya eh. Ang isang battle na hindi ka gumawa ng strategy has already been lost. Okay, so kailangan mo ng strategy, business strategy sa inyong corporation in order to survive. But let us put that aside because what we're going to talk about are the strategies that you are going to incorporate in order to accomplish your goals, not objectives, with the objectives in mind. Okay? Before I continue, I'd like to clarify that, Jong. If it is clear, again, a vision, a goal is a subset of a vision. Starts with a vision, eh? And objectives are subsets of the goal. Isang tabi. A strategy is not a subset of a goal, ah? Of an objective, but a subset of a goal. Keeping in mind the objective. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya one-to-one. Kasi ang ginawa natin kanina, vision, ito yung mga under the vision ng mga goals ng mga departments. Ito ngayon yung objective para dun sa goal na yon. Hindi tayo gagawa ng strategy bawat isang objective, hindi. We will keep in mind the objectives, pero hindi tayo gagawa ng strategy ng bawat isang objective. We're going to take the objectives as a whole, in the context of the objective, and create strategies sa ating strategic plan in order to accomplish the goal, keeping in mind the objectives of the project. Clear, John?
Got it.
Okay, I'm sure ang dami nandiyan ng mga questions. Ha? I'm ready for it.
so far, so good. I think they're
ready tayo for that one. Like I said, this is just a 1 hour. I do not expect that people will really grasp it right away. But revisit and revisit this training. And then we are also offering a full-blown workshop to further drive the point home. So I do not expect talaga, that is too much to expect talaga in this 1 hour, that everybody will get it. My vision may not be accomplished. I might not be able to get there, but I am going to do that if it takes time. It will take time. It will take another training most probably. So do not put yourself down if you do not get this right away. Okay, so, but I will try to the best of my ability. Okay, so it answers the question, what will we do para magawa natin yung goal na yan? Keeping in mind with the objectives para ma-reach natin yung vision. So it answers the question, what will we do? Okay. So again, vision natin. Transform your employees into valuable long-term contributors. Hindi ka kaya ang isang oras dito, Jong. 2:04 na. Okay lang ba?
Yeah, let's just manage whatever slides we have left, ba? I think
mga 100 slides in the joke. Okay, yung goal natin in line with ABC's vision of employee transformation, di ba sabi natin 'yan. Ang objectives natin, yung objective, ang strategy ngayon natin is number one, engage, align employees with organization. Keeping in mind that the objectives are offer ongoing employee. Ito yung talagang steps that we're going to be taking. Ito yung action items that we are going to be doing in order to accomplish the goal that will get us where we're going, which is the vision. Ito na ngayon yung mga project. John, ito na yung project. Gagawa tayo ng engagement program that will align the employee with the organization's values and goals. Gagawa tayo ng employee education program. Magde-design tayo ng formal onboarding plan. Magse-set up tayo ng feedback system. Ito na yung ating mga project. Ito yung projects natin. Ang gagawin natin dito. So in doing the project, did we get it?
So far, okay.
So under these projects, we have an action plan. Tawag nila action plan. Ito na ngayon mga steps in order pa what isa kaninang project magawa natin. Okay, it is the how of the strategy. How will we do it? How will we do that project, right? So, yan na ngayon yung ating plano. Let's skip na lang ako kasi I'm sure that everybody got it in order to expedite on time. No? Actions to, madami tayong tactics or plano under each of the strategies. No? Ito yung mga activities that the team is going to engage in. Ito na yung project plan mo. Right? Project plan na to, yung ating pinag-uusapan. Let me give you an example. Dun sa ating kaninang strategy, offer ongoing education and support. O, ito plano ko. Mag-provide ako ng coaching. Ito yung ating goal pala, di ba? So, ang strategy ko, provide coaching to accelerate performance. Ito ngayon, ang aking mga action items or tactics. Sa isa kong strategy, develop, customize training method, meron ako mga tactics. Okay, so, ito ang aking tactics for the strategy, provide coaching to accelerate performance. Okay? Clear, John, naman?
All good.
Okay, use the chat box para ano. I am here all day if you can give me your whole day. Kasi I do not expect talaga. Pero I hope kahit pa paano I have brought clarification in that fear talaga. Kasi natatawa ako, ito yung magbibigay ako talaga ng group discussion or what. Dun sila takot na takot. Mama, ano ba talaga yung goals or objectives? So I hope so. We created this program together. Let's put everything together. Lahat ang pinag-usapan natin. Vision natin. Transform new employees into valuable long-term contributors. Our goal, in line with ABC's vision of employee transformation, the HR department kami will create an engaging and informative onboarding program for ABC's new hires na matatapos by November 2020. Ngayon, ang aking mga objectives dito, within the month of the hire, of the new hire, ito yung mga gagawin ko. Now, ang strategy ko, tactics ko muna, under the strategy, kasi alam ko na yung strategy ko, ito yung mga action items ko, ito yung plano ko. So alam natin, the tactics are subsets of strategies. Strategies, not subset of goals, of objectives, but of goals. Our goals are subset of vision. Okay? I hope that these things are clear, no? This makes things clearer pala. Sorry. Tapos, pero associated pa rin yung strategies objective. Kasi kaya mong ginagawa itong mga strategy na to to meet also the objective. So in a way, as a whole, not isa-isa. Kasi yung ginawa natin dito, strategy under one goal. Objectives under one goal. Goals under one vision. So, let's take a screenshot pa SS. Done? SS done? Proceed, John?
Yes, go ahead, ma'am.
Okay, then. I hope everyone got to take a photo of that one. Kulit ng ating slide. Okay, so just to conclude everything and to drive the point home, I will be redundant. Let's watch this.
Goals, objectives, strategies, and tactics. You hear these words a lot in the business world, and often they're used incorrectly. Goals may be characterized as strategies. Strategies may be referred to as tactics, but it's essential to know the difference because goals, objectives, strategies, and tactics have distinct meanings. With a clear understanding of what each of these words mean, you'll be able to write more articulate and accurate program plans and proposals. So let's take a closer look at the definitions and some examples. A goal is defined as a broad aim toward which your efforts are directed. It's a what, not a how. In other words, it tells you where you are going rather than how you will get there. Typically, goals are broad statements such as educate customers on healthy eating or grow employee participation in wellness program. Objectives are closely tied to goals, and the two terms are often used interchangeably, but goals and objectives are different. An objective is a specific and measurable milestone that must be achieved in order to reach a goal. Some examples, increase customer attendance at health fairs or increase employee registration for a weight management program. A strategy is a plan of action designed to achieve an objective. Strategies tell you how you're going to get there, the overall direction you're going to take. For example, inform consumers about health fair through loyalty program. Work with store directors to inform employees about weight management program. And finally, a tactic is a specific action step required to deliver on a strategy. Tactics are what you do, and for every strategy, there are a number of tactics, such as send all customers in the loyalty card database a postcard with details about a health fair, or provide store directors with a fact sheet about weight management program to distribute at a weekly meeting. And now that you have a better understanding of goals, objectives, strategies, and tactics, you can develop and execute more effective plans. And you'll be able to clearly articulate what you're doing and why you're doing it.
Okay, so to conclude, a vision is a direction. It answers the question, where are we going? A goal is a broad primary outcome, and it answers the question, what do we want in order to accomplish that vision? An objective is a measurable, na metric yan, a step you take to achieve a goal. It answers the question, how do we want to do it in order to get what we want, in order to get where we're going? A strategy answers the question, what will we do? And is a subset of a goal. Okay? And a tactic are the action items under a strategy and answers the question, how do we go? So hopefully, we have brought clarification in our lives and we are ready for your question.
If there are parts of your ISO that you think, you know, where you need help the most, if you can just type it there, because this one, this topic on objectives, targets, and program setting, we just got, this is a feedback from one of you participants. So that's why we thought of organizing this. And I hope this gives you really an idea on how to really effectively set your goals, your vision, mission, objectives, goals, targets, strategies, and all that. So let us know which part of your ISO implementation do you need help the most? Is it on the SWOT analysis? Is it on risk assessment? Other than, you know, setting objectives, targets, and programs. I hope you're able to really get at least a small value, if ever, just to really improve your target setting right there.